Did you know that Nikola Tesla had around 300 inventions? These are his most interesting inventions that helped make him a legend. One of his most famous inventions was the Tesla coil, which he invented back in 1891. The Tesla coil is technically an electrical resonant transformer circuit. We're not going to go into how it works because, honestly, we don't know the mechanics of how it works, but we're going to tell you some of the cool things it can do. Tesla ran a whole bunch of experiments with the Tesla coil, including electrical lighting, X-ray generation, and high-frequency alternating currents. The most ridiculous thing it can do is wirelessly transmit electricity. Oh yeah, the Tesla coil is also a radio transmitter. It might have actually been the world's first radio, and we'll get into that story a little later. But Tesla coils are mainly used today for entertainment and educational displays. Basically, it's just because of how awesome the effects look. However, Tesla coils are dangerous. Tesla coils, by their nature, produce electrical arcing that can travel unpredictably in any direction. And they can strike pretty far, so these arcs can be quite dangerous. But if things fell one way instead of another, who knows? Maybe the world today would be getting electricity completely differently. Tesla was backed with $150,000, which is a little over $4.5 million in today's money. He was backed by one of the greatest bankers of our time, J.P. Morgan. Tesla wanted to build a tower that would have been able to transmit wireless communication by voice, images, and text. You know, kind of like what we're doing today with our phones, except way earlier. The tower would have injected electricity into the Earth at the right frequency and harnessed what Tesla believed to be the Earth's own electrical charge. Basically, it was supposed to be a huge Tesla coil. The coolest thing about the tower is that it would have been able to transmit wireless electricity. Tesla had the vision of providing free energy for the world. J.P. Morgan signed on because he was extremely interested in the wireless capabilities. However, you did hear about that last part about wanting free energy for the world, right? Well, that was sort of a big problem for our guy J.P. here. If the energy was free all over the world, how would he have made any money? J.P. couldn't figure out how to meter and charge for the electricity that would have been going on with the tower, so he decided to abruptly pull his funding, and that was a wrap for the tower. Tesla also had another interesting invention that was supposed to be a defensive weapon that he called Teleforce. However, it was conveniently called the Death Ray by the media. It wasn't a machine that could shoot laser beams like something out of Star Wars, but instead it relied on energy in the air and electrical force to shoot particles at whatever it's aimed at. Tesla claimed that this super weapon supposedly would have been able to put an end to all war, as it would have been able to bring down, quote, a fleet of 10,000 enemy airplanes at a distance of 200 miles from a defending nation's border and will cause armies to drop dead in their tracks. Tesla attempted to get funding from J.P. Morgan's son, Jack Morgan, but that didn't happen. He then tried to get some countries to fund his device, but only the Soviets partially tested it. For some reason, it wasn't ever manufactured by any country. Tesla claimed that thieves had tried to steal his Teleforce invention, but the thieves, or spies, left empty-handed. He said that there was no danger that his invention could be stolen. That's because all the plans and blueprints for the Teleforce weapon were all in his head. The X-ray actually is implemented today. However, here's a little interesting fact about X-rays. Tesla accidentally produced the first X-ray images in the US in his laboratory when he was experimenting with Crookes tubes. That was an early experimental electrical discharge tube that shot out electrons. Tesla started noticing damaged film in his lab, so he became super curious and decided to study the X-rays, which was still unknown and unnamed at the time. He produced his first X-ray images when he tried to take a photo of Mark Twain. He eventually managed to get images of the human body, which he called shadow graphs. Unfortunately, a lot of his early work in X-rays were lost when his lab in New York caught fire and burned down. This is a big reason credited with the discovery of X-rays. Then there was Tesla's concept of an earthquake machine. The earthquake machine was a steam-powered electric generator that was patented by Tesla back in 1893. However, what Tesla had actually intended his machine for wasn't to create earthquakes. It was supposed to be a replacement for the inefficient reciprocating steam engines used to turn generators back then. Tesla was really fascinated with resonance, so he did a lot of experimentation related to resonance. The oscillation of the machine was adjustable, and Tesla used the machine to set frequency in experiments. Tesla claimed that one time he was running tests with a small version of the oscillator in New York City, and the oscillator generated resonance in several buildings. This is basically a fancy way of saying an earthquake. The shaking grew larger and larger, and for some reason, he wasn't able to shut it down, so he was forced to break his machine with a sledgehammer. He later claimed that he was able to build one of these machines that could destroy the Empire State Building. We don't know what the practical application for an earthquake machine could be. Who knows? Maybe a Bond villain would have a use for it. Tesla was one of the early experimenters of the radio back in the late 19th century. However, he got into another situation just like the X-ray. He came out with a radio-controlled boat that he called the Teleautomaton. He showed off the boat during an exhibition at Madison Square Garden, and he had hoped to sell his idea to the US military as an application, but there was little interest. Although Tesla wasn't the first to experiment with radio, there's been a lot of debate on who's the real inventor of the radio. Here's what happened. Tesla had discovered his Tesla coils could send and receive radio signals when they were tuned to resonate at the same time. In early 1895, Tesla was ready to send out a signal from his lab, but the same fire I had talked about earlier took out this work in the lab too. You would think that he would have backed up his copies of important papers back then, right? Unfortunately for Tesla, Italian inventor Guglielmo Marconi was working on his own wireless telegraphy device, and Marconi filed for a patent in England in 1896. Tesla filed his patent in 1897 in the US and was granted the patent in 1900. Marconi tried to file a patent in the US in 1900, but of course Tesla already had his patent in place, so it was rejected. Marconi then revised his application for the next 3 years, and suddenly, in 1904, the US Patent Office reversed its previous decisions and decided to give Marconi the patent. But wait, this story gets better. Fast forward to 1943. The Patent Office reversed its decision in 1904 and restored Tesla's patent, although they declared their reversal had no bearing on Marconi's claim to be the first to achieve radio transmission. What? How does that even make sense? Tesla came up with his first induction motor back in 1887. George Westinghouse, owner of Westinghouse Electrical Company, heard about Tesla's development. He wanted Tesla's motor and related power system. He negotiated a deal for Tesla's designs and hired Tesla as a consultant to work for him. However, in the end, Tesla's induction motor still needed much further development. Westinghouse was strapped for cash, so the development of Tesla's induction motor stopped. This is another instance of Tesla almost bringing the future to the public much faster. Maybe if certain things had happened differently, our parents would have been already driving electric cars for decades. Watch this next video to find out how this kid is living the GTA lifestyle.